boys and girls, welcome back. Tone King here, coming at you live from the Tone Lounge. This is a celebration, day number one, 30 pedals in 30 days. Today is November 1st. This is the fifth annual 30 pedals in 30 days. And in true Tone King fashion, I'm going to kick it off with a tradition. And that tradition right here is the latest and greatest from Amp Tweaker. This is the Tight Metal Pro. I did a little unboxing earlier on. Hopefully you check that out. And after having unboxed it, read the manual, played through it, I'm going to call this the game over pedal. It has everything going on. So you got to hear a little riffage and lickage. Now let's talk about the pedal a little bit. First of all, the Tight Metal Pro is the next revision of the Tight Metal pedal made by Amp Tweaker. Amp Tweaker is founded and the pedals are built by James Brown. If you don't know who James Brown is, click the link below. I'm not talking about the soul singer. I'm talking about the amp builder and pedal designer. The guy behind the 5150, yes, the Eddie Van Halen 5150, the guy behind the Schecter Hellwind amp series, the guy behind custom amps and a slew of other things. He is a name brand killer in the industry when it comes to great tone and great amps. So that's who he is. You could read that below. The link to the unboxing I'll also include below. Now let's talk about the pedal. Excuse me. Handmade in the USA, complete kind of rolled steel enclosure. You got the bumper guard. You have an on-off switch, which is true bypass. You have a boost switch, which engages a boost volume and a gain boost. So not only does the boost give you decibel, it also gives you more gain. How cool is that? Okay. The cool thing also is you have a universal, he has the sidetrack. James Brown may have the only pedal that has these sidetrack, and there's three of them here, okay? You have the boost loop, the universal loop, and the sidetrack. Now, just to be clear, this could easily be a 45-minute demo, and I may do a follow-up video to this, but for the sake of time, because we all know our attention span is not 45 minutes, so we're going to try to keep this video within 10 minutes. Too late, I'm already about 6 minutes in. But anyway, I'll try to go through it real quick. Stay with me. So when the pedal is off, this sidetrack is on. So let's say, as an example, you're playing metal and you want to go clean. When you turn that off, it engages the sidetrack. So if you want to have like a nice chorus or something real subtle and shimmery, you could plug that in here. When the pedal goes on, it turns that off. Okay? So that's sidetrack number one. Universal loop is something that's always on. Let's say you like a tad bit of reverb and you're clean and you're dirty, you put it in the universal loop. And then you have the boost loop. So let's say you use that for solo, you can have a delay pedal in the boost loop, okay? And when you unboost, that goes off. Three separate loops, depending on if the pedal's on or off, depending if the boost is on or off, and something that you like all the time. Active EQ, low, mid, and high. You have your gain, and then you have the trademark tight switch, okay? Which you kind of have to see it and hear it. It will make it bigger, fuller, tighter. There you go, tight. So just keep your ears open when I get to that. And then you have a boatload of other things. This will behave like a 9-volt or, this runs on 9-volt or 18-volt, one or two batteries. There's a dual battery compartment that slides out and is held in by magnets, no screws or twist knobs or anything like that. You just pull the thing out. Again, check the behind the scenes video where I actually do that and show that to you. So you have that, runs on 9 or 18 volt, which is kind of like the difference between a 50 and 100 watt amp, as James Brown noted, and if he noted it, I take his word for it. And then you have a couple of things. You have this mid-boost function, so you could get additional boost, which goes on with the boost foot switch. You have a thrash setting, you have a smooth or edge setting, and then you have additional gate. So if you want more gate, you could get it. And then you have an additional high setting. When it's plugged in, you get the LEDs. If you have it running on batteries, you have an on-off switch, okay? Also, this could be a preamp, which means you could run it right into the effects return, or you could run it right into the clean channel of an amp, which is what I have on right now. Okay, last but not least, that's a lot of information. Definitely check out the owner's manual online, because it will show you what each of those functions are. Okay, and this is it. This is it. It's like a little fold over pamphlet. Okay, it'll show you what all of those functions are, and it will give you the example of how you can use it. And if you notice the bottom, if these controls aren't enough, you have dip switches inside. You could switch it from 9 to 18 volt. You could do more noise gate, and you could set the effects loop to be pre or post. And then you have a fat rhythm, fat boost switch for even fatter attack. Game over, right? Now, I'm going to zip it because that was a lot of information. Now let's listen to it. I'm going to give you the clean channel, clean sound, and then keep your eyes on the controls. Here we go. We'll be right back. Did you catch that? Listen to this. When you have a high gain pedal and you do what I just did without a gate, you will hear noise. And a lot of times when people demo it, myself included, I'm not going to lie, you reach for the on-off or the volume on the guitar, right? So check this out. If you don't have a gate, this is what you hear when you stop playing. Watch. You hear all that? That's what you hear. Now watch this. I'm not going to touch the volume. How's that? Built-in noise gate right there. I didn't kill the volume. I didn't turn off the pedal. Clean as a whistle. Like I said, game over. So, boys and girls, there it is. That is video number one. That is, again, I'm going to say it again, game over. I don't think you will find another pedal that does what this bad boy does. And I got 29 more days to go, so it's going to be a fun ride. And just remember, every pedal, there's hundreds, maybe thousands of different pedals on the market. And when you're purchasing a pedal, when you're buying a pedal, you have to find what's right for you. If you're a tweaker, as the name suggests, amp tweaker, you will not find another pedal that comes close to feature, function, and tone. And I clearly highlight and tone because the guy that makes this pedal is a hitman in this industry. James Brown, he made, he was the guy behind the 5150 circuit. There's a lot of artists that use his tone, and he nailed it out of the park with his own company called Amp Tweaker. And I am proud to show this pedal. I know I'm not the greatest guitar player, but I dig what I do. I dig the gear, and I dig this pedal. So if you like this video, let me know what you think. Leave your comments below, thumbs up, subscribe, all that good stuff. Lots of links below on this pedal. And remember, I didn't even scrape the surface. I'm going to tell you one more time. If you boost that, you could have a loop that's engaged when you boost. All the time, you could have another loop, which is adjustable in the back. You could put it before or after. I'll give you an example. Wah pedals usually sound good before the gain. Reverb and delay pedals sound good after. So if you want to put a wah in the universal loop, you select it pre in the little jumper under the battery cover. If you want to do delay or reverb, you put after. Okay, so very well thought out. If you're using batteries, which some people dig, you could turn it on or off so you don't drain the batteries. You have the sidetrack. So when you turn the pedal off, if you want to have something in here, maybe it's an EQ pedal. Maybe it's a chorus or a flanger pedal or something. When that pedal turns off, this sidetrack goes on, okay? You have the mid boost, okay? You have this soften, the smooth thing. You have the thrash setting. You have the high gain. I mean, it's packed. And you know what? This is far, far from a gimmick pedal. This thing is dripping in tone. Made in the USA, all metal steel construction, bumper guard. It's an impressive pedal. It's top shelf, high quality, both in the design, the designer, the overall, the whole thing. Game over. Hope you enjoyed this video. Leave you off one of those. Thanks as always for watching, and until next time, rock on. Later.